In 1532, a Spanish adventurer, almost illiterate, Francisco Pizarro, rode into Peru with no more than 62 terrible horses and 106 foot soldiers. And overnight, he conquered the great empire. How? By cutting the top of the pyramid, by capturing the Inca. And from that moment, the empire sagged, and the cities, the beautiful cities, lay bare for the gold plunderer and the vultures. All that remains is the work of the mason, the beautiful craftsmanship of the men who made this city, not the Incas, but the craftsmen. The masons carried in their heads a stock, not so much of patterns as of ideas, that grew by experience as they went from one site to the next. They also carried with them a kit of light tools. They marked out with compasses the ovals for the pointed vaults and the circles for the rose windows. They defined their intersections with calipers to line them up and fit them into repeatable patterns. Vertical and horizontal were related by the T-square, as they had been in Greek mathematics. The wandering builders were an intellectual aristocracy, and they called themselves Freemasons as early as the 14th century.
In the lodge that I belong to, we had a Muslim apply for membership. And the membership of our lodge didn't know how to initiate him because we knew we couldn't initiate him on the Holy Bible. So we wrote a letter to the Grand Lodge of Alberta asking him for instruction. And a letter came back stating that we should place the Koran and the square and compass beside the Bible and the square and compass on the altar and initiate him with full honors.
The Masons are using the entertainment industry in particular to condition people to their way of thinking, either openly or subliminally. The methods they use vary, but the goal is the same, to impose their beliefs, their ideology and their objectives on you in such a way that you begin to think of them as your own. Evidence of their presence within popular entertainment is widespread. Masonic involvement in the industry is not a new thing. Hailed as one of history's great composers, Wolfgang Amadeus Mozart, a Freemason himself, composed a symphony, which was an open display of Freemasonry. The symphony is based on a story taken from Egyptian mythology of Isis and Osiris. The pagan rites of ancient Egyptian mythology form, through the Kabbalah, one of the fundamental aspects of Freemasonry. It is from these same pagan origins of Egypt, the symbol of the one eye stems.
Hi, I'm Jim Mars, and I've always been interested in secret things, alternative stories. My background is as a news reporter, and I learned early on about the so-called secret societies. My question was, do they really exist? And more importantly, do they have any power? Over a period of 30, 35 years, I have studied, read, talked, experienced, and I want to tell you, they're real, they're here, and yes, within the inner core elite, they definitely have power. And I think this is an anathema to the whole concept of a free, open, and democratic America.
We have before us the opportunity to forge for ourselves and for future generations a new world order, a world where the rule of law, not the law of the jungle, governs the conduct of nations. When we are successful, and we will be, we have a real chance at this new world order, an order in which a credible United Nations can use its peacekeeping role to fulfill the promise and vision of the UN's founders.
You know, all people, even in religion, mm-hmm. All people have been deceived at one point or another. And many are deceived now. They are deceived by the Satan, the devil, the chief devil is the Satan, himself. And he has deceived people in all faiths. That includes Judaism, Christianity, and Islam, and other religions that I don't need to even mention here. You knew how I loved you, but my spirit was weak. Laughing at the questions that you once answered me. Do you know where you're going to? Do you like the things that life is showing you? Where are you going to? Do you
talking about this, had so much information. By the way, here's another picture of Mr. Trotsky. Did you know he was from the Bronx, New York? He was editor of a communist Jewish newspaper in the Bronx, New York. He left with money from American Illuminati Jews and went over and joined with Lenin to found communism in Soviet Russia.
Okay, the Illuminati have their own programming for their own people, for their own way of life.
Okay, so they're 100% programmed, they have themselves.
Yes, and that's really what we're talking about, is the Illuminati programming that's been developed over the centuries and millennia.
That's what I'm talking about. I wondered about who was programming them.
Well, that information or that programming initiated eons ago when this planet was colonized, and it morphed into what we have now over the millennia. It's really the same thing, new version. Okay? Now, what else do they do to people who maybe are necessary but not programmable? You're seeing it happen right today, is on the news weeks ago. What are they doing to those other people? Chips. Putting chips in them. The chips can override mind pattern and tap directly into the nervous system and manipulate brain waves. We're going to learn how that works tomorrow when we look at frequencies and hertz levels and when we do the parts on technology.
As long ago as the 60s, a scientist named Delgado was able to stop a charging bull in its tracks using a radio-controlled implant in its brain.
Anybody can look this up anywhere. I'm not making it.
Do you know where you're going to? Do you like the things that life is showing you? Where are you going to? Do you get what you want?